Hi, good evening. And you know what? I can see it in Samira's eyes, but I'm not heartbroken with the attendance, because I'm one of those rare breed who makes documentary films which nobody watches. So I'm, and before that I used to do theater, which also 30 years back nobody used to watch. The kind of theater one used to do. So I'm very used to breaking my heart over not having the audience. So now I've decided after 40 years that I'll not be disappointed. So I'm actually not so disappointed. I think it matters that, 10 people are interested, so to have a conversation rather than having a no conversation show. So thank you very much, Samira, Edgar, Mumbai Local, Junoon, for inviting me here. I have been on a long hiatus from the city, so this is actually the beginning of my rehabilitation in a way, so thank you very much. Okay, so what I'm going to talk about is actually a much larger project called Project Cinema City. It was a big project. I don't know, some of you may remember, it happened in this city from 2008 to 2014. It was a 6 years long project where 100 artists, architects, filmmakers, and social scientists were involved. And we looked at the city, and our argument was what is there in the invite also, that the city that produces steel is called Steel City. The city that produces cotton is called Cotton City. Similarly, Coal City. So what do we produce? I mean, we of course had a history of being a textile industry. Mumbai also had a history of being a chemical industry, but now we don't do anything. We don't produce anything hard, which we generally know as industrial. But what we actually produce, which is not an industrial good, but we produce that at an industrial scale, is image. And more than that, moving image, cinema. So it's not a good, it's not that we can take it home, it's not that we can present somebody on their birthday or at their wedding anniversary, it's not consumer's good. Nor cinema is an industrial good. It's not aeroplane, it's not automobile, it's not a railway track. So why I'm saying that cinema, why do you say, we all the time say, we read it in the newspaper, cinema industry did this, film industry is going through crisis. But then how it is an industry? And if it is an industry, if we, for the time being, accept that that is an industry, and that is our main industry in terms of economy, in terms of visibility. Because you go abroad, people say, oh, Bombay, Mumbai, Bollywood. You may like it, you may not like it, but that is one way of identifying this city. And even the border states, which find it that Bollywood has been very hegemonic. I mean, say Manipuri cinema, Bhojpuri cinema, other cinema who are very hostile, but they also come here because the industry runs here. So to do a special effects, to do a stunt, to get a studio facility, to do post-production, editing, music, they also come here. Even if they think that actually they are becoming extinct because of Bombay cinema. So that's industrial nature of it, that it is more than only the films that we watch and get entertained. I mean, that was our argument in 2008 when we looked at this project Cinema City. So I, to start with, I'll show you. So if we decide that cinema is the main thing that we produced, that means cinema will then decide, will or may not decide. If you disagree with me, please stop me in the middle, because that is what it is, because we are talking about today and this city, this place. So there has to be a dialogue. It cannot be a lecture, because it's not about past or not about some kind of speculation. We're talking about our time and our place. So the migration pattern, people who come to this city, where they live, the hierarchy of space, you know, what is your address? Earlier, I mean, people who are as old as me in this room will remember that before cell phone days, the phone number was a very important indicator of who you are. if you had a bus, phone number starting with 6, then you are somewhere around Bandra. If you have a phone number with 2, then you are somewhere in South Bombay. And with 8, that means you are, you know, really north. But now, thank God, with cell phone, we are not in that trap. But so this city has a very hierarchical relationship with space. Where, who lives where, and which space is allotted to what work, what function is very important. Does cinema influence it? I'm just putting some questions which we'll explore in the evening. So that is one thing, that space layout of the city. Does does it get influenced by the production that the city does? And in our case, it is cinema. Okay. Like in an industrial town, it will be workers' quarter, it will be the factory place, it will be the officers' quarter, it will be the workers' recreation. That is how the spatial layout happens. What happened in Cinema City? Yeah?
One hint I can give is the one film, Dombivli, I think a recent release, maybe 6 months, a year back. Dombivli.
Yeah.
Right. So yes. It was concerned about the citizens' plight and, you know, people who have settled. I think that that was the main aspect.
Yeah.
So that came into my mind.
Yeah.
You were telling about the people who, old people settling down and traveling all the way for what?
Yeah.
So in the local center. So that that is a point which I want to make.
Sure.
Thank you.
So I'm today, sure. What we are going to look at it, what is that to do with cinema as an industry, as this gentleman said? So one is that how labor migration happened, how the space gets laid out for what function, for who is a proper citizen, who is considered as a proper citizen, who is not. Another thing is the rhythm of the city. Say anybody, any one of you have ever lived in industrial town, then you will know that the siren of the factories actually determine the rhythm of the city. Like 6 o'clock shift starts, 9 o'clock shift starts, 5 o'clock, we don't have industry anymore. So what decides the rhythm? Last train? Last show? Last cinema show? What decides the basic rhythm, the common rhythm of this city? So these are the few questions. So I'll show you a small clip.
आंटी एक मिनट, रेशमा जी है ना जिन्होंने शोले में काम किया था, उनका घर पता है आपको?
रेशमा,
वो टांगे वाली जिन्होंने शोले में काम किया था? भाई साहब, रेशमा जी जो है ना जिन्होंने शोले में काम किया था,
यहाँ से लेफ्ट कर लेंगे ना आप, कॉर्नर में एक पुलिस चौकी है,
इनके सामने पुलिस चौकी है, उसके सामने लेफ्ट में जाओ, नीचे एक पान का दुकान है, दुबे पान वाला बोलो, वो आपको बुला देगा। रेशमा,
शुक्रिया
भाई साहब, थैंक यू भाई, शेर बाबू।
तो फेस दिखाने का 1000 है और फेस छुपाने का 2000 है। हम फाइटर में जाते हैं तो फाइटर में जैसा गांव की लड़की बताया है या कोई शराब खाना बता रहा है, उसमें टेबल से गिर, टेबल पे धक्का लग के गिराया या फाइट हो रही है उसमें लेडीज गिर, आग लगी हुई है, लोग भाग रहे हैं, ऐसे सब शॉट रिस्की होते हैं मगर उसमें हम लोगों का फेस नज़र आता है, तो वो फाइटर काम हो गया, उसमें हमको 1000 रुपया पर डे मिलता है। और अगर हम किसी आर्टिस्ट का डुप्लीकेट, चाहे वो बूढ़ी हो जवान हो, किसी का भी डुप्लीकेट करें तो हमको 2000 पर डे इस वक्त। तो हमको फेस दिखाने का 1000 रुपया है और फेस छुपाने का 2000 रुपया है। लोग बोलते क्या, अरे क्या शॉट हेमा मालिनी ने दिए, अरे क्या शॉट उस आर्टिस्ट ने दिए, तो जी चाहता है जाकर उधर खड़े हो जाए और कहे कि भाई ये लोगों ने नहीं दिया, ये शॉट मैंने दिया है। लेकिन मैं वहाँ जाकर कहूँगी भी तो लोग समझेंगे क्या पागल वागल हो गई जो स्क्रीन के पास आकर कह रही कि तसल्ली कर लेते जाने दो, उसका पैसा तो हमें मिला है ना। पहले से मैं बिंदास टाइप थी इसलिए मुझे इतना ज़्यादा दिक्कत नहीं आई। फिर भी दिखने में तो मैं लड़की थी और खूबसूरत भी थी माशाल्लाह उस ज़माने में, तो ऐसा जाने आने में लोगों ने परेशान तो करते थे। मैं मुझ में एक ऐसी आदत, एक बार दो बार तीसरी बार माफ़ करती फिर धो डालती थी, जब पढ़ती थी तब लगता था कि अरे गलत नंबर पर हमने डायल किया था। चल बना के लिए पान सादा, कौन सा पान?
सादा बनारसी पत्ते,
बनारसी में सादा बनना पड़ेगा। राइडिंग मैंने कुछ जाकर सीखी नहीं है किसी के पास, पाई दुनी करके जगह है उधर के हम रहने वाले हैं, वहाँ पर ऐसे 5 पैसा दिया उसमें राउंड में बैठ गए ऐसे ही करते थे। तभी हमारे बड़े चाचा के लड़के थे वो बोलते थे ए लड़की जाते है घोड़े पे बैठती है ऐसा ऐसा, मार भी देते थे मगर हम जरा ऐसे लड़का टाइप थे तो वो चले गए तो वापस बैठ जाते थे उसके ऊपर, वही चीज़ हमको वक्त पर काम आई। और आज भी शोले जब लगती है तो आप देखिए आपको हाउसफुल टिकट मिलता है, यानी शोले हिट हो गए तो हम भी हिट हो गए। अमृता जी का सेम ड्रेस का मेरा इस देर ये तस्वीर, मेरी पहले की तस्वीरें आपने देखी तो आपको क्या कुछ कमी नज़र आई कि मैं सिर्फ स्टन वुमेन ही हो रह सकती हूँ, मैं कोई हीरोइन नहीं बन सकती थी।
This is Reshma, who is a star in her own way, but who is completely unseen. So cinema, which is so much, it's a public culture. It's not like theater, it's not like literature, it's not like music. You may be a connoisseur of that art or you may not be. Cinema is something is overarching. Everybody watches cinema. And everybody has watched Sholay at least, definitely. But here is this, and everybody remembers Shole by these sequences. But actually the body of that sequence is completely unseen. Now this is a kind of labor that goes into cinema. So if we are saying that cinema is what we produce, then which are the bodies and what is the kind of labor that produce that cinema are actually completely unseen in the city. And interestingly, Reshma watches her body again and again in a huge magnification. Shole was a first 70mm film that we produced, if you may remember. And she watched that, which is faceless. Her body, and body is not that it is kone mein kahin, you know, at the corner of the frame. It's not, it's at the center of the frame. The whole country was talking about that body which jumped into the cart. But still the body is not seen, because the face that says dialogue, chal dhanno, the character is remembered by the face, by the dialogue, and character is not remembered by the body performance, that is the stunt that has been performed, though we have seen the performance. We know chal dhanno as much as we know jump on the cart, but we don't know who jumped on the cart, but we know that who said chal dhanno. This is the nature of labor, and a large number of citizens of this city are that kind of labor. But it was not that, you know. See, this is a poster of silent era cinema, 1930s cinema. This is Sulochana. Yeah, she was a Rabbi. No, she's Rabbi Meir. She Ruby Meir. She was a Jewish woman from Calcutta who was such a big film star in 1935 that the rumor is that her monthly salary was as much as the governor of Bombay. She used to get 5,000 per month in 1935, highest ever paid in the industry, and those were the days women were paid at least twice more than the male actors, because at that point in that decade one genre of cinema was very famous, that was women action. You may remember the Hunter Wali, you know, it's still very famous. But Hunter Wali was only beginning of a particular genre. You know, Bombay industry has this habit. One successful film, then everybody makes films like that. So it was same in 30s also. So they were following Hunter Wali, there was Chambuk Wali, Burkha Wali, Cycle Wali, there was a series of films. So women who could do stunt were huge stars in those days. That was the requirement for stardom. And lots of people who could not speak Hindustani could act because it was a silent era. As soon as the dialogue came, and then dialogue became important for us to watch the film, we start identifying stardom by the dialogue delivery. You know, Shah Rukh Khan aise bolte hai, Devanand aise bolte hai, Hema Malini aise bolte hai. So we go by the dialogue, but in silent era, the body was important, body performance was important, and lot of people whom today we'll call outsider. That is some Jewish people, and of course South Indian people, Burmese people, from the whole subcontinent. Then Nadia, the famous Hunter Wali character, she was half Greek, half Wales. I mean, she was a mix of many races, which had nothing to do with India, actually. And she was a very big star. So it was possible. It was possible that a woman's body, a woman's performing body, a woman's body which performed action in this city, in this industry, was actually a big draw. But that has changed. So there is nothing different between Sulochana, whose salary was as much as the Viceroy, and Reshma. But Reshma gets 100 rupees to show her face, 1,000 rupees to show her face, and 2,000 rupees to hide her face. So that means she better opt for hiding her face. So here is a job in the most visible industry, that is cinema industry, where you get paid double if you hide your face. So that is one kind of labor. This is another kind of labor.
जैसे एक ऊपर वाला क्या करता है, एक सिक्का ऊपर से छोड़ता है, एक सिक्का ऊपर से छोड़ता है बराबर 3:30 बजे या 4:45 बजे, तब तक के गाड़ियाँ निकली है, फ्लाइट उड़े हैं, कई लोग बस से आ रहे हैं, कई लोग लग्जरी से आ रहे हैं, कई लोग टेम्पो से आ रहे हैं, यानी मतलब सुबह 4 बजे से शहर में चहल पहल शुरू हो जाती, अरे आवाज़ आ गया, क्या गिरा उसको पकड़ो, और सब उसको ढूंढने में लग जाते, ढूंढते 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 दुर्कर हो जाती है, जिसने जो पाया पाया, नहीं पाया नहीं पाया, फिर 1-12 बजे के बाद एक आदमी धीरे से उठता है, बस वो आदमी अपनी कहानी शुरू करता है, और शाम को 1 बजे तक तो वर्ल्ड घूम के आके 5-10 करोड़ रुपया ला के बोलता है, अब मैं 7 जन्म तक भी है ना चैन की नींद से सोऊंगा, मेरे बच्चों को भी तकलीफ नहीं मिलेगी। ये जो सिक्का गिरता है, इस सिक्के को हमें ना ढूंढने में लगे हुए कि ये कहाँ गिरा, अभी तक वो सिक्का हमने पाया नहीं, चलो कल गिरेगा, कल ढूंढेंगे, बस इस कल को अंत नहीं, और वो सिक्का गिरते रहता है और हम वो आवाज़ सुनते रहते हैं।
एक दौर वो था 15 साल पहले का कि जो मैं बम्बई आया हुआ था बिना टिकट आया अहमदाबाद से, लेकिन रहने की सुविधा न होने से मैंने बस से सिक्योरिटी की नौकरी हासिल कर ली। सोचा चंद दिनों में पासा बदल जाएगा, लेकिन आज तक वो किस्मत ने साथ नहीं दी। हमारा एक ही सपना था कि हम फिल्मों के लिए कहानियाँ लिखेंगे, बस कि फिल्मों में कहानियाँ, सिनॉप्सिस, स्टोरी, क्या बोलते हैं, स्क्रीन प्ले, डायलॉग्स, ये क्या चीज़ होती है, ये जानते जानते 15 साल गुजर गए। और अब इतना नॉलेजमेंट हो गया है कि हम खुद पिक्चर बना लेंगे, ऐसा नॉलेजमेंट हो गया है, क्योंकि सपना है ना वो, सपना तो हर आदमी देख के आता है। और मुंबई में उठ जो रात को गाड़ी में बैठते तो सपना देखते देखते मुंबई में आता है, सुबह हो जाती है, वही उसके लिए सबसे बड़ा सपना है। सबसे बड़ा सपना तो वही है कि हम कहीं से भी बैठेंगे, रात को ही गाड़ी चलती है, सुबह उठ के देखते हैं तो दादर स्टेशन आया, कोई बोलता बोरीवली आया, कोई बोलता वो उरला आ गया, कोई बोलता बांद्रा टर्मिनस आ गया। एक्चुअली क्या है CST भी आ जाता है, लेकिन क्या है वो मॉर्निंग में ही आते हैं सब, और हम लोग ऐसे ऐसे गाड़ी में बैठते हैं कि यहाँ मॉर्निंग में ही होना चाहिए, मॉर्निंग ही होना चाहिए, क्योंकि मुंबई में जाके हम रात को कहाँ रहेंगे, कहाँ सोएंगे, कौन से गेस्ट हाउस में जाएंगे, कौन सी लॉज ढूंढेंगे, ये भी एक सबसे बड़ा सवाल खड़ा होता है। यहाँ के लोग जो है वो रात को आ जाते, लेकिन बाहर गांव के जो भी लोग हैं वो सुबह ही आते हैं। ये खास खास बॉम्बे का वैशिष्ट्य है। यानी मुंबई में सपना नगरी है, वो सही में सपना नगरी है। हम 24 घंटा वही सपना देखते हैं, ये गाड़ी आ गई, चल अभी जाएंगे, अभी चल उधर पहुंच गया, उधर हो गया, अभी पिक्चर रिलीज हो गया, करोड़ों रुपये आ गए, दैट इज थिंग फॉर द सेटिस्फाइड फॉर लाइफ, अपने लिए, बाकी कुछ नहीं। बाद में देखा तो कुछ भी नहीं, चाय के लिए 2 रुपये नहीं है तो कोई बात नहीं है। मिलते हैं हम लोगों से, लेकिन लोगों को ये बताते नहीं कि मैं राइटर हूँ, किसी को बताते नहीं, लोग आपस में समझ जाते हैं कि राइटर है, लेकिन वो मेरे से उम्मीद नहीं रखते। क्यों उम्मीद नहीं रखते पता नहीं, उनको कहीं ऐसा डर तो नहीं कि वॉचमैन है, वॉचमैन है थर्ड पर्सन से, उससे क्या बात करने का। अगर वॉचमैन है, इतना बड़ा राइटर है, तो वॉचमैन की नौकरी क्यों करता है, ये उनके सामने एक क्वेश्चन बन जाता है, और मेरे सामने उसका जवाब नहीं है। मेरे सामने एक ही जवाब है कि मैं वॉच सिक्योरिटी हूँ, ओनली फॉर सिक्योरिटी। मैं अपने पेट के लिए हूँ, मैं अपने गुजारे के लिए हूँ, मैं अपने वक्त के लिए हूँ, लेकिन उनके सामने तो ओनली सिक्योरिटी।
So I mean it's, it goes on, but you got the story. Now why I'm showing it in the context of labor, my argument is, so this man, he thinks he is a writer. Nobody else thinks so. Since nobody else thinks so, so he decides to play a role, an impersonation of a night watchman. But he obviously thinks that, but morning he will wake up to be the star writer, Shah Rukh Khan of writing world. So every day he lives a life which he thinks he is play acting, because his actual life, which is the writer's life, is actually hidden because nobody is ready to accept it. But it's only a matter of time. This has taken 15 years. That means it basically has taken his entire adult life. And that is where a whole lot of cheap labor in the industry comes from, because this man will not fight for the better life for the night watchman, because night watchman's his role acting only for one night. Tomorrow morning it will be another story when he will be the writer. He will never become a writer. Then he remain a cheap labor, because in his mind he is temporary there. He will not fight for the case of the temporary self, because he is interested in his ultimate self, which is a writer's self, which, as you can make out, one in million maybe one some dream comes true. These dreams also come because one or two such stories are there. There was a legendary star cameraman, cinematographer Ashok Mehta, who started as a tea vendor in the industry. So there are millions of tea vendors who will be a tea vendor in the film industry at any cost, at any salary, because they all think they will be Ashok Mehta tomorrow. There is only Ashok Mehta, but there is millions of tea vendors. Similarly, I look at it this way, that everybody is play acting, because everybody is thinking that tomorrow it will be another morning. And really, oh, subah kabhi to aayegi, you know, that kind of concept. It's a very filmy concept, but it's a lifestyle. People live their entire adult life in that filmy aspiration and produce very cheap labor for this city and for the cinema industry. So similarly, a space. A slum hut man always will think, one day Danny Boyle will come and shoot in my hut. It will never happen. Because Danny Boyle will always make a elaborate set of dharabi and shoot there. But you always have that dream. So a temple, an ordinary structure is thinking, tomorrow I'll be a studio. A hut will think, tomorrow I'll be a location. A night watchman will think, tomorrow I'll be a writer. Reshma will think, tomorrow I'll be Hema Malini. So everybody is living for that tomorrow. And I was talking about rhythm. So that is the rhythm. That is a rhythm of aspiration, but it's also a rhythm of absence. A permanent absence, but you go on living the permanent absence because you think tomorrow will be something else. So, what happened, Edgar? Iska? Yeah. Sorry, yeah, yeah, please. Yeah. It's not even a fiction. Who has given Dhananjay any fiction? Dhananjay only is making his own fiction. It's living in fantasy, I would say. Yeah. Fiction is somebody has put together a story, and his story is shocking, but he has made that story. Yeah.
What's, I don't know, it's making me think of one of the things that I've always wondered about Bombay is how come Bombay puts up with so much?
Yeah.
You know? And it's just a very interesting way of looking at that putting up, because if you don't think this is your reality, obviously you can put up with a... it's sort of like you're taking us into the way the psychology of a city is in some sense created. But the other question that I'm always wonder about is the industry, the film industry itself, which is able to evoke such fantastic dreams in people. I mean, Bombay really is a crucible of that. So, I'm hoping you want to come to that. But yeah.
That's why we talk about commodity. We cannot take it home, but we are already have taken home. Also, another thing is that, this is what is then being sold as resilience of Mumbaikar. Big thing, we celebrate all the time. Because we can take any hardship because you all think tomorrow will be O Subah Kabhi Toh Aayegi. So we go on hoping that, and we go on tolerating and go on producing cheap labor. So this is the aspirational labor. But there are people who actually made it. Say an artisan, embroidery worker, a zari worker, a painter, a carpenter, when they have first shifted to the industry, industry has really lured them from all over the hinterland, and they become salary, they become urban labor. They do studio system, so they were paid monthly, and they thought they made it because they came to the city, and the kind of money they earned was unthinkable in a village setup. But then what happened to that kind of labor? So it's a small clip from a long film.
इसका कोई फोटोग्राफ नहीं है
हां जी
ये मेमोरी है ये जो लगा है
हां हां
और ये फोटोग्राफ से किया हुआ है हमारी पेंटिंग है बहुत सी ऐसी है जैसा कि
मैं आपको देख रहा था हां मुझे बड़ी मजा भी आ रहा था और हैरान भी हो रहा था
ये हैरान क्या ये फोटोग्राफ मुमताज का फोटो देना और इस चीज को कंप्यूटर वाला लाइट करके छाप के दिखावे हां ऐसा ब्राइट करके दिखावे इतना गाल उसकी मशीन इतना ब्राइट करके दिखावे आप बताइए कंप्यूटर बनाता वो है कि आर्टिस्ट जो हैंड से बनाता है उसमें उसको गोरा भी करता है काला भी करता है इसी को हम चुड़ैल भी बना सकते हैं ग्रीन ब्लू में बना देंगे इसी ब्यूटी को इसके दीदे बाहर निकाल देंगे तो ये नागिन भी हो जाएगी चिंगारी निकाल देंगे तो ये हिरन चुड़ैल भी हो जाएगी
रेवन भाई अतुल भाई के पिताजी आपको जानते हैं
हाँ हाँ क्योंकि मैंने उनसे बात की तो मुझे पता है और वहाँ पे
आज वो गुलचंद टाकेस की बात की होगी उन्होंने वो
गुलशन टाकिस बहुत लास्ट में यानी टाकिस बोल रहा हूँ मैं
हाँ हाँ
उसका नाम था बम्बई थिएटर
अच्छा रहमान भाई
हाँ जी
आपसे ये भी पूछना था
क्या
कि अभी समझो जैसे आप अभी ये रंजीत को पेंट कर रहे हैं
जी
हाँ तो कभी कभी ऐसा होता है ये फिल्म स्टार जो है
हाँ
तो उसमें जैसे कि अभी समझो मुझे राजेश खन्ना पसंद है
ये
तो और उसको अगर मुझे मैं पेंट करता हूँ
हाँ।
तो एक एक, एक, एक पर्सनल लगाव उसमें आ जाता है
सही बात है
तो जब समझो अभी रंजीत है वो मुझे पसंद ही नहीं है
मैं आपको बताऊँ
हाँ जी
कि अभी ये तो फिल्म लाइन है
हाँ जी
फिल्म लाइन का छोड़ दो ऐसा मैं जाते अगर बनाने बैठूंगा
हाँ जी
तो जिसमें मेरे को लगाव है जैसा आपने हाँ बोला हाँ। मैं उसी का बनाऊंगा
हाँ जी हाँ
है क्या नहीं
हाँ जी
अच्छा नरगिस पसंद है हाँ। बना दिया मधुबाला बना दिया मीना कुमारी बना दिया और तुम्हारी माधुरी दीक्षित की भी बन के गई प्रेम प्रतिज्ञा ना
हाँ,
प्रेम पर
प्रेम हाँ।
वो दो पिक्चर देख के मैंने झंझोर वहाँ से मैं उसका फैन हो गया
अच्छा
और मैं खास करके उस पर ज़्यादा ध्यान दे अभी भी बाहर लगी हाँ। है
तो ये वो शोले का अमजद खान
शोले का अमजद
हाँ जी
और अरे बाप रे ये तो एकदम उसका हो गया भाई एग्जीबिशन आर्ट हो गया
हाँ जी
ये अलग है
हाँ ये अलग है वही
ये बैनर लाइन
हाँ
इसमें हम हाँ अब रंजीत विलन है तो उसको डिफरेंस देना है सबसे
हाँ,
अलग
हाँ जी
तो उसको अलग किया जा रहा
हाँ,
पिंक और माओ में उसमें किया जा तो विलन का तो ज्यादा करके ग्रीन ब्लू पिंक बैनर लाइन में ये रखा गया आज तो अभी आपका विनेल जो है उसमें तो विलन भी वही कलर में हीरो भी वही कलर भाई हीरो ये है कि वो है
तो सही बात है
कप इनटू दिस पीपल ही वाज एन आर्टिसन And he thinks that he can compete with technology. Nobody can compete with technology. He is the last person. But when he was brought here, he became an urban labor. And labor soon become an industrial waste. But an artisan does not. Where he was, they are a painter. It's a more of a collective. Then when you get old, you get absorbed. Then you become a master craftsman. But here he is not a craftsman. He is denying it, but there's a desperate denial that a computer cannot make it red. Of course, computer can make it red. Computer can make it much more gradation than he can even think of. But this is like he could hear. He could hear his end with the technology. And this is I think 6-7 years back I took this interview. And by now, this must have closed shop. This is the guy who used to paint 30 feet by 40 feet, 6 banners every week, and they used to get erased like this. I mean, we can't think about how temporal this art is. I mean, Madhuri Dixit getting, everybody getting shocked how Madhuri Dixit's face is getting erased. But every week they bring it out, this 30 feet by 40 feet banner, and they erase it and they repaint on it. Today, a computer printout will have a flex printout which you cannot erase, but it becomes a waste. So there is a very unique way of making a Rahman is a waste, and flex printing is also a waste. So we are actually, I mean, the cinema industry is actually also producing lots of human waste and material waste, and we need to think about it. I mean, that is how Bombay is also getting shaped by this. A whole lot of people who are completely obsolete in their skill, because it's not only actors make the film. Actors are a very small part of the industry. It's various skills that make, and that is craft and also science and now computer-based skills. And those skills are getting obsolete by the day, and huge amount of human waste is being created. So that's also could be a major social problem. I mean, I suspect that the aspiring people who come and don't get any work, and people who get work become obsolete and waste very soon because it's a very small span. It's not really an industry that you will work there till the age of 60. It's not that. Another interesting thing is that it's not only film. So around film, so many small industries come up. Dancing, acting classes, grooming classes, salon, these, that. So it's many ancillary industry which has spread around the city, which is city's main economy. All these event managers and weddings are being shaped as a film event. So that's also our economy. It involves whole lot of people's livelihood. So that is why I'm saying that cinema is the only industry that we have. Not because the films that we make, but the thing is that how many people and what kind of network, what kind of space is involved with this. So that is what is labor, what is the input, who make it, who put their labor into it. But in order to become an industry, you also need to have a loyal set of consumer. Somebody will make it and somebody will have to buy it. Otherwise, it is not, again, not an industry. So here is one piece on the consumer.
पहले तो मैं तो संगम में देखता था, दर्पण में, फिर राम और श्याम जोगेश्वरी में, हंजर में, गोरेगांव सम्राट सिनेमा, टोपी वाला, अनुपम, मलार संगीता, नेवरा कस्तूरबा, कांदीवली में मिलाप, सवेरा, बोरीवली में, बोरीवली में उधर है दो तीन टाकीज है वेस्ट में,
जया
है और एक और भी है, एक बाजी मार्केट के बाजू में, तीन सिनेमा हॉल है, तीनों में देख, ग्रैंड रोड में भी देखा, ग्रैंड रोड वेस्ट में भी, स्टेशन के बाजू में.
देखो सच्चाई आज कितनी बढ़िया से खुल रही है, कभी मुझे नहीं बताए.
तो अच्छी बात है, देखा तो बुरा किया क्या? बुरा किया?
बहुत बुरा किया.
क्यों?
मेरे से पहले शौक अपना पूर कर लेना अच्छी बात है. अब मैं छोड़ने वाली नहीं हूँ.
पिक्चर देख के रहना.
कांजूर मार्ग में भी देखा, दो टाकीज है,
देखत रहा.
उमा और हिना, भांडुप में एक सिनेमा हॉल है, उसमें भी देखा, डोबीवली में भी देखा,
मुझे जलाने का कोशिश मत करो,
कल्याण में भी देखा.
हाँ, जलाने का कोशिश मत करो.
भिवंडी में भी देखा.
खाली देखा क्या? देखा तो
पिक्चर देखा सिनेमा हॉल.
तो उसमें क्या करते थे वो लोग?
पिक्चर दिखाते थे पर्दे पे, और पर्दे
खाली पर्दे पिक्चर दिखाते थे. अब तो घर में है, थोड़ा देख लेती है अपना. शौक भी कम हो जाती ना, जैसे जैसे उम्र जाती है वैसे वैसे इंसान का सब शौक कम हो जाता है, महंगाई हो जाती है. अब तो एक पहले इतना टिकट का दाम नहीं था, आदमी 100 रुपया लेके जाता, अपना नाश्ता भी कर लेता, टिकट भी कर लेता, घूम के चले जाते. अब तो 100 रुपया, 100-150, 200 रखो खाली टिकट का. तो शौक जिसको है और भगवान दिया है तो रख सकता है, और शौक लाख हो नहीं है तो क्या क्या मेरे शौक नहीं है? मैं भी सोचती हूँ 10,000 का साड़ी पहनूं, मैं भी सोचती हूँ कि ब्यूटी पार्लर जाऊँ, मैं भी नहीं कुछ तो 3 लाख के गाड़ी में बैठ जाऊँ, नहीं ज़्यादा है तो मैं भी फ्लैट में जाऊँ, नहीं बड़ा मिले तो एक ही हाल किचन मिले. क्यों नहीं शौक होता? शौक कम पड़ता है, कम मरता है सब. कि जब 100 में एक भी नहीं मिल पाता तो 100 के 100 मर जाते हैं उसी लिए, और 100 में से 1-2 पूर हो जाते हैं तब आशा लगी रहती है, चलो ये नहीं वो मिलेगा.
सो दिस इज So this is, of course, I mean, this whole hypnotism, urban infrastructure that hypnotize the migrant community, and this is one addict, of course, but this kind of addicts. You remember people used to say, I have seen such film for 21 times. I mean, there used to be competition, how many times you can see one film. Those are really committed consumer. But there is also a gender angle to it, because that is only accessible to the man. The woman doesn't have it. I mean, she's also migrant, she's also same aspiration, but it's not available to them, available to her. But this is one point which everybody talks about, but I want to talk about another point, what space cinema actually has given to ordinary women. I'll show you a small installation that we did on this. We interviewed a whole lot of people, women, older women, saying that what cinema meant to you. And people have come up with excellent ideas. Where is my this thing gone?
Being alone by yourself, maybe cinema provided them with that, you think? That they are alone with that screen and themselves. Theater had started. Now this Madhushree was so important because it was the first time ever that a Hindi film was being released in an air-conditioned theater, which we had heard had pushback seats. And my parents went with my sister for some reason to town and three of them watched it. Now the Liberty Theater one is in itself a very important place, much talked about. Plus, it had Raj Kapoor, Dilip Kumar and Nargis, the top actors in those times. Plus, Lata Mangeshkar's first hit songs came in that. So Lata Mangeshkar suddenly had become a phenomenon. And I so much wanted to see, to this day I have not seen that film.
So, the drive-in theater at Bandra in Bombay was at Bandra East. And my God, it was an experience of its kind. Every Friday there also we used to go every Friday, first day hota tha, and we used to go for the night show. And sometimes it used to be very bad because those huge queues, there was no advance booking over there. First come, first serve basis. And in the car only you had to take your car, it was like those toll nakas that you have, those people were at the entrance sitting with the tickets and then they would count the number of members in the car and give you the ticket. Then they were, like we have speed breakers. Like that there used to be bumps like this on which you parked your car this way. And sitting in the car you watched, there was that huge screen in front of you.
Abhi ye parda hai, jaisa beech mein parda aaya. Aap udhar baithe, main idhar baithe. Beech mein machine lagaya. Jo bolte na chalate, wo machine. Pura log, pura road bhar gaya. A line mein pura road bhar gaya. Beech mein parda. ऐसा नीचे भी जाते थे आते थे ऐसा पर्दा ऊपर बांधते थे
नीचे क्या
नीचे मतलब ऐसा इतना अंतर बांधते थे ना पर्दा तो नीचे से लोग आते जाते हैं उधर से इधर इधर से उधर ऐसा जाते हैं लोग
वांटेड देखना था सलमान खान सबका फेवरेट तो सभी को सब फर्स्ट टाइम जा रहे हैं तो थिएटर में सलमान खान को देखना तो बड़ी अजीब बात यह है कि सबने सुबह सुबह बहुत सारा मेकअप किया था पर उधर जाने के बाद जब मैंने सबको कहा कि आप लोग बुरखा उतारो और अभी बुरखा उतार दो हम लोग अंदर जाएंगे अभी हम लोग जा तो थिएटर में रहे पूरा अंधेरा कुछ नहीं आपको दिखेगा सब बाथरूम में अब तक निकल क्यों नहीं रहे तो मैं खुद गई देखने क्योंकि फिल्म शुरू हो रही है तो मैं अंदर गई सबके बाल खुले सब मेकअप में लगे हुए और मैंने ये क्या फिल्म स्टार्ट है चलो जल्दी फिर फटाफट सबने बाल वाल बनाया इतने अंधेरे में फुल मेकअप में सब बैठे थे
जहाँ अभी मनीष मार्केट है यहाँ पर एक रेडियो सिनेमा होता था
चंदन
अनेक कोई नूर टाकिया
मतलब हिंद माता में देखो गेटी गैलेक्सी जेमिनी अंबर ऑस्कर माइनर देन संगम नवरा
प्लाजाला दीपक टाकी जिला
ये अप्सरा है एम्पेरियल है नास
एक साल हो गया टाउन गेट ऑफ इंडिया नरिमन पॉइंट और सब देख के आए मरीन ड्राइव लुक्स इक्वली अट्रैक्टिव एंड इक्वली डिस्टेंट
मैंने फिल्मों में देखा था और ऐसा जगह सब फिर हकीकत में मैंने जाके देखा तो मैंने बोला देखो ये पिक्चर में ये सीन है ये रोड है ये पानी है ऐसा गेट ऑफ इंडिया ये सब है ऐसा बोलने लगा मेरे बच्चों को ऐसा मैंने देखा
this is the very special relationship that women had when we used to see cinema in large magnification, where cinema seeing means an activity. That means you decide, you take time off, you navigate the city, you decide whom you are going to watch with. So we are coming to the infrastructure which now vanished because we are now don't see so much cinema in the theater, at least not in those neighborhood theaters. So when this woman says that pichle saal main shahar gayi thi, what she means, she lives in Santa Cruz, she doesn't live in any village, but for her, city means Marine Drive. Why? Because she has seen for, when she was watching Parda cinema with the whole village, with the whole neighborhood, whole night sitting on the road, as she said, and there was a curtain, there was a Parda, and we could watch the film. And what she saw is that Amitabh Bachchan in Diwar running around the promenade. So much before she saw her own city, she saw Amitabh Bachchan. So Amitabh Bachchan is her image. She negotiate her own city through the image of Amitabh Bachchan running through that place. You remember Mukaddar ka Sikandar kahlayega, first time we saw Marine Drive. So it's okay, first time somebody in Manipur or Kashmir saw Marine Drive in that cinema is okay. But somebody who lives in Santa Cruz also saw it first time there. So for somebody living in Kashmir and living in Santa Cruz, Marine Drive remains as dreamy, I mean equally dreamy for both. And then in that magnification, whether you watch Alps or you watch Marine Drive, it all become equally distant and equally familiar. So it's all become the image through which you then start negotiating your daily life. So when you actually come to Marine Drive, you only can think of what you have seen in the film. And that also happened because it is not you are alone. Because your whole khandan, your whole neighborhood, your whole village watched the film together. So it's a common reference, which is not true today. So it has a common memory, it's a common language. Actually, we have so much language issue. Only common language we have is actually Hindi cinema. Whether we like it or not, it's true. It might create kind of hegemony, but it's true that that's the only language because that's as a common reference. You remember in that scene, immediately many things are clear, but which may not happen anymore because we don't watch collectively cinema. So I'll show you how cinema halls worked. So now we come to the third part of the industry. So we talked about labor, we talked about who are the consumers. Now I'm talking about infrastructure. So theater is the main infrastructure. You'll have to watch. So see, 1911, these many theaters were there. Okay, I mean, not by number, I mean, go by. So then the city is growing and cinema halls are growing. 1931. Then 1951, see, the city is growing and more cinema halls are coming. This is the heydays of cinema. Okay, 51. 61, more. So actually you can see the city is spreading, city is expanding, city is developing. One way to how to make out is that if you see how the theater halls are made. So this is the time that a neighborhood was known by its cinema hall. We used to give landmarks, no? Take right from Bahar, then you come to Chandan, take a U-turn at Chandan. Or there was thing that Mughalism has to be seen in Maratha Mandir only. And Sholay has to be seen in Minerva because Minerva is only the 70mm screen. And Mughalism because in front of Maratha Mandir, Shish Mahal was created. So it's not that koi bhi film kahin bhi dekh liya. Wo particular film particular jagah mein ja dekhni hai. To iska matlab that you will go with your friends, but your grandmother will also go with her friends to Maratha Mandir to see Mughalism. It may happen 6 months after you watch Mughalism, but she will also watch it. This is how a collective culture was created. A neighborhood was known by it. And then, of course, that our own memories of seeing a film, whom did you see it? Was it your first love? Was it your first cigarette? Was it your first touching hand? Was it the first time you ran banka college? What? I mean, there are many, many. Today you can watch it on your cell phone. I mean, there is no such particular day, particular person, particular space, particular emotion. And then you can see what's happening from 1971, that is Sholay days, thick, lots of theatres coming up all over the place. I mean, before people are reaching, cinema halls are reaching before that. I'll tell you a story. In Goregaon West, it was 70s. After the Sholay, we talked about herd mentality in Bollywood, right? That one film gets successful, then everybody tries to make it. So suddenly lots of multi-starrer films came out in 70s, which needed big screen. And South Bombay already had no space. It was always a very dense space. So all cinema halls started coming up on the north side, towards Thane and towards Borivali. And those theaters were all meant to be for the multi-starrers, big scale, so 1,500-seater, huge. Actually, South Bombay doesn't have that kind of big theater. And there was nothing in those areas. Goregaon West was full of tabelas. You may remember, I mean, though you are, some of you are very young, the going by train and only thing you could see are the buffaloes after buffaloes after buffaloes. I mean, I remember when I came 30 years back. And those were the days, cinema halls of 1,500-seater, there are not even 1,500 people in that area, started coming up. One such one is called Samrat. Now, Samrat, I find this story very interesting. We went to research about Samrat because Samrat was one first huge theater that came up in 70s. And people said that we didn't know what is a cinema hall. We have not gone to a cinema hall. So we thought the government is making a night shelter for our buffaloes because they get bugged by the mosquitoes. Mosquitoes bahut katte the, madam. So we thought that for our buffaloes, tabela banaya ja raha hai. So very interesting that urban infrastructure, big, today think about Goregaon West. Mind space is in Goregaon West. I mean, one of the biggest high rise. So only 50 years back, urban infrastructure has not reached, but what has reached? Cinema. I mean, how urban infrastructure ever reached in those agricultural land, only in the mid 70s, post Sholay, is through cinema, to show cinema. I find this story very exciting. So this is that 70s, lots of theaters coming up. But after that only 80s, you can see it's started closing because actually it did not have that kind of economy. See 90s, already reduced. 2001, time of multiplex. Yeah, and quickly I'll tell you a few stories behind a few theaters and that's the end of it. This is Bharat Mata. Bharat Mata Theatre is still on, it still has not gone, it's one of the very few, it's in Parel. I mean, you still give direction that Bharat Mata ke, flyover ke niche U-turn karna. I mean, this one instruction is still valid, it may not remain valid very long. But if you remember, next to Bharat Mata is still there, there is a United Mill structure, it's an old mill structure. You know what it is? That in the 30s, workers for the textile industry were brought from the villages. And they were not used to working in an industrial setup. Wo to season hota hai to kheti karte the. Cultivation ka rhythm hota hai na. So rhythm of a particular economic affair is always different. So their rhythm was that in a rainy season you do cultivation, then you do some aram after the harvesting, then you again work. Here, every day you will have to go in, shipped in and out, shipped out, they could not cope. And they used to run away to Gaon. So they had to be glued. So many industry owners inside the textile industry campus started cinema hall. Bharat Mata is one such cinema hall which started in the campus of United Mills. Some theater hall, United Mills, actually, the mill structure is still there behind Bharat Mata, and Bharat Mata is also still there. So Bharat Mata now belongs to National Textile Industry. After United Mills, which was a private-owned company, closed down, state-run National Textile Industry bought it, and so Bharat Mata is actually property of National Textile. Now, interestingly, that those days, sometimes some cinema halls, which are the mill cinema halls, they were called mill cinema halls, they used to run shows 24 hours. Like how? Maybe three shows only, but it will be like if your shift gets over at 2 in the afternoon, then one show will start at 2:30. The next shift gets over at 10 o'clock in the night, so the next shift will start at 10:30 in the night. So it is to run by the shift of the mill, and there are three shifts in the mill, so there are three shows, but not like 3 to 6, 6 to 9. It is by the shift. So 24 hours there is to be screening. That is how actually audience, consumer for the cinema was actually cultivated. Another cultivation is women. In the, again, in the 30s and 40s, the Devika Rani, when Devika Rani was star, people used to, the stars were sent for the Zanana shows. You remember Zanana shows ran till 90s actually. I have also seen films in Zanana show. That matinee show, that is 3 to 6, was reserved for women only. Okay, and that was a big craze for women. I mean, they would go in whole gang, housewives who otherwise couldn't go in, once the children and the husband come back, they cannot go, they cannot get entertained. So that was a public life they had. It's called Zanana show. And in that Zanana shows, female stars were sent to cultivate audience. Women were an important audience. Once Manmohan Shetty said, when I take a shot, I think of the burqa clad neighbor of my my neighbor in Girgaon. She is the most important audience for me. I'll have to entertain her. So women were a very important composition in that era for cinema. There used to be creche inside the theater. In Lamington Road, all the theaters used to have creche inside. And there also used to be a feeding room where you can get the audio feed. That means you can hear the dialogue and you can feed your baby. So you don't miss on the story. All these facilities have gone, as if women don't need to feed babies anymore. Or I mean, we have so many things in multiplexes, but we don't have a creche or a feeding room, as if women don't need to feed babies anymore. Okay. This is a place which is not very far from here, which is called Falkland Road, which is also called Pila House, which is very interesting, which is actually part of the, I mean, the red light area, Kamatipura is in this area. Do you know the why it is called Pila House? Because in 1850, much before cinema, British government earmarked a district called, you can have public entertainment only in this area. Because public entertainment is demoralized. Same story as it is now. So who all had gone there? Circus, kusti, magic, street performances, and sex workers, brothel, all gone into that corner. But what that area was, that Falkland Road now, I mean, behind Grant Road, which is just 10 minutes from here, it was actually a Muslim graveyard. So unlike today's practice, nobody broke any darga, any mazar, nothing. So all the brothels and all these houses which is to show kusti and magic and circus came around the dargahs and the mazar. Later on, all this place had many theaters. I mean, in 20th century when cinema came, it all converted into cinema halls. In 2 kilometers area, there used to be 18 cinema halls there. Now, even now, there are 7 cinema halls alive. Moti, Sagar, Alfred, you may have heard of some of the names. They're still there. Now, those cinema halls are very interesting because those mazars and dargahs are there. So they're in the compound. So you enter a compound, you first see a mazar. So you pray there. Then you go inside, and these are old cinema halls, and it's a red light area. So you, what you watch basically is a 3X film. And according to me, that's super urbanity, that you pray, that sacred, and you go inside and watch a 3X film that is profane, and that everybody knows, nobody is hiding. I mean, nobody is hiding that it's a 3X film, nobody is hiding it's a dargah. I mean, and you attend to both with equal sincerity, equal interest, so to say. So people will pray quickly and run because they're getting late. Even today, the ticket price there is 20. And it's not bad. You go and watch a film, I have seen. It's fantastic. Rehman actually is from that area, who's that hoarding painter. So this is those cinema halls, lovely cinema halls. And because real estate has not picked up there, so they are still there. This is a 1912 poster from that area. I'll end with this. Okay. this is shows, this is this pre-cinema, so it is about kushti and bodybuilding show. And here the ticket rate, they are saying reserved stall 3 rupees, reserved box 2 rupees, box 1 rupee 8 anas, stalls 1 rupee, stalls backlines 12 anas, prostitutes 1 rupee, ladies 4 anas. So basically, there is some mistake here. If you read it, you cannot read it. Can you read it there? Yeah. So basically, the sex workers are charged the same price as adult men. Okay. And women are given concession, children are given concession, then it's a, so there are two ways of looking at it. My ultra-feminist friends say that, oh, so sex workers are exploited. But I would say that they are respected as earning adult. I mean, which other women, the society ladies, were not given that respect, they are given concession. And these people are not given concession, they are given a working person's status. Depends on how you look at it. I don't want to determine on one. And this was in 1912. Can you imagine today that there is a category officially announced as a consumer's category called sex worker? It's a poster. Okay, so we end on Amir Khan, which is, just one. So it's also, it's, you know, this is a neighborhood space, this is a community space, pranks, love, growing up, breaking heart, running away, all this is to happen. This was a space, it's not only the film, it's the space. Multiplex, of course there are multiplexes everywhere, people go, maybe 150 is not all that expensive anymore. But what happened is that, here I want you to, you know why multiplexes have come up? Multiplexes have come up because all these theaters that we talked about are actually are given at a very concessional rate. The land was given by the government because they wanted to encourage cinema halls at that time, urban entertainment. And now, and the condition is that if you want to change the land use, that you want to change it for something else, then at least 1/3 of the land has to be kept reserved for the same cause. That means if you have taken it for public urban entertainment, then you make it into a shopping mall or a housing society, but 1/3 of the space you will have to keep it for urban entertainment. So it's a big, so the builders are in a tight corner. So that's why you will see sometimes some multiplexes, you don't know why they are kept on. They're kept on because of this. Nobody goes there, it's badly maintained. It is on the highest floor of the shopping mall in the darkest corner when rest of the places is much more cinematic and entertaining like this. Children going up and down is much more colorful. You don't need to pay money. Only gated zone in a shopping mall or in a multiplex is the cinema hall. So it's because it has to be kept. Even if it doesn't run, even if there are two people, because the shopping mall is running on the land which was kept for cinema. So that's the whole thing. Yeah. That's it. Please.
Suggestion would be to keep theatres in the shopping malls. Create theatres in shopping malls. And
shopping malls
some people, we come all the way to NCPA.
Ah, theatre.
Yeah, theatres. Okay. Like Prithvi Theatre.
We neither own the shopping mall.
I think that will have more creativity and even the teenagers space. Will, instead of just going for an experience of movies, they can have theatres,
sure.
Theatrical this thing, right? Yeah. So I think that will be the more, there is a suggestion.
Yeah, he was to say something.
It fact, thank you very much for educating us, especially on the aspects of the theaters in the campuses of textile mills, as you gave an example of India United Mills, and the film shows catering to the mill workers' shifts. Now, as per the maps that you had given us over the decades, the number of cinemas had gone up. Are those cinemas still there and the land there utilized for the same purpose as you mentioned, urban entertainment, or have they been usurped by builders to be used for other purposes?
Yeah, that's it, that legally they can... actually, there is an association called the Single Screen Cinema Owners Association.
Sorry?
Single Screen Cinema Owners Association.
Okay.
Okay, they are very unhappy. They all want to change. They all want to start a shopping mall.
Right.
Okay, actually, no. Even Bharat Mata manager Kapil doesn't want to run it. I mean, you and I may feel romantic about it, but economically, everybody wants to turn builder. They cannot. So whatever theater is still running, yes, including Lamington Road Theater,
yes,
because they cannot change the land use so easily. Some people, of course, changed it and they don't really run a cinema hall. They run something else. I mean, you know, Bombay real estate is so murky.
Yes.
But the law says that 1/3 of the land must go for the same purpose. Interestingly, this Samrat story that I told you, that people thought that government is making a night shelter for the buffaloes, that's Samrat cinema. Samrat was the first one to convert into a multiplex called City Light. Anybody who lives in that side will know the
Dadar.
City Light. Yeah, in the 90s, the first multiplex. Right. So the first theater which came up there, 1500 seater, was the first one to become a multiplex. It became four screen, but it's sitting capacity came from 1200 to something like 699 or something. It reduced. So you must understand that it's no more encouraged such big, because economically it's less audience, more expensive ticket, than more audience, less expensive ticket. The economy is different. So though more theaters have actually, if you go by number, then more theaters has come up. But actually, the sitting capacity, the seats have gone less than half.
Achha, now, as you mentioned, Lamington Road, one very popular cinema there called Apsara.
Yeah.
That has now changed into a totally commercial building. There is no cineplex there. How have they managed it? Is it with some manipulation of...
Some nepotism, after a point you get scared because the builders will be after you, you know, can't even
live
in it, you know, it's a big thing. But there was another theater in the same vicinity, you remember Minerva, which actually Ocean had bought. They demolished Minerva and then they did not get permit. They wanted to start a film school. At that time the BMC said that a film school is not the same purpose, it's not the same land use. So they could not make it.
In fact, to be very honest,
but it's not strict as he's talking about. The Apsara has a completely different thing. So builders can handle it. Ocean cannot handle it because Ocean is a cultural institution.
You're very accurate. In fact, the owner of Ocean's, which owns Minerva, Neville Tooley, he's my school classmate.
Ah, okay.
So when I ask him about it, he's quite evasive about it because there could be some
he
change.
He thought he will manage it, but he could not. He is quite smart, but he could not handle it. Yeah. Ultimately, he's not a builder. You know. He
yes, true.
Smart, yeah.
True. He's more of an art collector and an auctioneer. You know.
Hi, I'm quite young, so this single screen theater movement is something that was quite there when I was, you know, five or something.
Yeah.
But I want to ask, there are a lot of single screen theaters that are still there and that are still working. But rather than maintaining them properly and showing popular movies, we see Chudail Ki Atma, or you know, all those B-grade movies that are popular in today's time. So why is it that they don't evolve along with the audience's taste?
See this. This I'll have to read because I cannot remember this. I thought you will get bored, so I didn't know you will be interested in this. In order to encourage investment in entertainment sector, Maharashtra government offers the multiplexes total tax exemption for the first 3 years. Multiplex owners don't pay any tax for first 3 years, then a concession for next 4 years. Hence, while a single screen hall with ticket priced rupees 20 would pay rupees 9 as in entertainment tax for each ticket sold, a multiplex with ticket price at rupees 250 would pay nothing for the first 3 years, rupees 66.25 for next 2 years, and rupees 99.38 for another 2 years. I mean, just try to get the scale. I mean, you don't have to remember all the numbers, but the scale is, see, I mean, 20 rupees ticket, that is the Grant Road cinema halls, you'll have to pay 9, okay? And then there was no bar on our ticket prices. So at weekend, at one point, ticket prices to go for blockbusters, 500 or things like that. Only from 2014, I think, that there is some kind of greed has been brought. Otherwise, there was no greed either. I mean, people used to charge anything. So Maharashtra state, but it must be true of other states also, I don't know about them, definitely want multiplexes to happen. And the clause under which multiplexes are dealt with by the state is called good cinema, cause for good cinema. So just because people whistle in the single screen theater, so that is bad cinema, and just because people don't whistle in multiplexes, that's good cinema. And they pay less tax than those people. So those people also don't want then. Why Grant Road cinema owners will want to run it for 20 rupees to give the government 9 rupees? But they are stuck. They're not, because maybe a multiplex may not work in that area. You know, there are many other economy happens. A builder has to be interested in that. And but it's a matter of time.
Bathroom. So this is really very interesting, Manushree. Though of course I have been, you know, seeing bits of it at the museum and of the project I'm talking about, and it also got me wondering also because in a way it still continues to be, though the physical cinemas, as you said, are, you know, maybe a matter of time or everything, but it still continues to be, though it's all moved to webs and digital and everything, and become less labor intensive in that sense. So, you know, it got me thinking about all that and about the scope of your project. Are you planning to also continue and map that?
No, somebody else will do that. I'm true, I've done it for 6 years. No, not me, but this is ongoing thing, no? I mean, what urban entertainment and urban public life, what shape it will take? So it's actually not particularly cinema. Cinema was an anchor through which we were trying to understand urban public culture. You know, who all were there, public place means what, who all were part of it, who got excluded in the new technology. I mean, women are now Saturday, Sunday, they say, sitting in front of the TV. Ask women, honestly, I mean, take time off, ask your mother, ask your grandmother, do you really enjoy watching it on TV or do you long for that? Because TV means in the commercial break, she will have to give tea to all of you. She will have to make dinner. But when she went out, that 3 hours she had to do nothing. She was with her friends. She could also whistle in the darkness of the cinema hall. So ask, I mean, people say, oh, now the women get all the films on TV or maybe on computer also. But it's not true. It's not a question of seeing the film. It's a question of associated public life. So the public life of the city is shrinking or not shrinking is what I'm requesting you to think. Cinema is only one way of looking at it. You can look at it through football, you can look at it through, I mean, whatever, yeah.
So I am looking forward to the sequel of this meetup. I mean, I hope there will be more meetups like this.
Okay, thank you. He was to say so, they're both of them, yeah.
Hi, I just went to Odisha recently for the Konark Sun Temple Fest, and along with that, just before you approach Konark, there was Jatra happening. So I was just wondering, and I just saw, you know, like politician type posters, but they were actually posters of so many actors, actresses, and there were 5 different groups that had come. Each, you know, that sitting area was about 2,000 to 3,000 they could accommodate, so there were about 5. Huge, very, very huge ground, live entertainment happening, dances, and you will not be able to understand because initially 1 hour it's like dance happening in that, and there are the Hindi film songs, some of them are playing.
Yeah, prologue,
and,
long prologue. Yeah, yeah,
and then happened? And then when it catches, and it starts at 12 o'clock in the night. So it's so interesting. I went to see once, it was so interesting. I mean, just to see that amount of energy in the people, So that form of entertainment has changed. And there's Odia theatre happening actually in after
Assam
that. There's a play. And the stars are probably, you know, known in that area. I mean, they must be big in that area. So that form of entertainment, that live thing, what we maybe is coming back or it's changing. Like that.
It's the community.
Right.
There's gender angle to it. There is also across class. I mean, also
yeah, all types of people together. Came in.
Where else except train? Now, where else all sorts of people come together in Mumbai? They don't. They're getting more and more segregated. But theater was one such thing. Maratha Mandir mein Mughalism sabko dekhta hai. Mughalism print was brought in elephant. It could have been brought in a car, in a Cadillac car or whatever, but it was brought in elephant because the and it was gone around the whole city before coming to Maratha Mandir, because people must know that here is a big thing happening in the city. That is the opening of Mughalism. So people all came. There was a Sikh Mahal. There's ticket booked for 6 months. But that's okay. You will wait for 6 months. That wait is also very exciting. Tumne dekha? Nahi, nahi, maine nahi dekha. But I got a ticket for such and such day. Right. Things like that. There is also an interesting thing. You know why it happened? You remember Jubilee show, Golden Jubilee show, Platinum Jubilee. These days, I mean, Shah Rukh Khan, Salman Khan star don't happen more than 4 weekends. Why? Nothing to do with Shah Rukh Khan and Dilip Kumar. It is, there was a cement scarcity in the 60s. Okay, especially in Maharashtra, because the Antule or the chief minister was called as cement minister. Guess it's something cement. Apparently, he has done my major ghapla was cement. So there's a cement scarcity. And the state government said, unless something is essential, don't make any new building. And non-essential building, one was cinema theater. So for more than a decade, no cinema theater could be made in 60s. But by that time, talkie has started and cinema industry has become majorly prolific, so more and more films are coming out every year and there's no theater to show them. So the distributor became very important. So then one cinema can be shown only, one film can be shown only in two cinemas or something. So then the long wait for it. So it was like, then the cinema crisis was over. But distributor was paying very heavily, the government bureaucrats saying, keep on saying there's a cement crisis and there should be no new theater. So public life is also built by corruption in the political life. It's not separate, you know. Yeah.
Similarly, this kind of culture is not only seen in cinema as such. That could also be music or cultural program wherein people get together. Yeah, yeah. Again, this is a matter of convenience for them to get together, probably.
But today you will not even get permission. Today it's a matter of culture also, na? I mean, convenience happens, okay, it is part of your culture. To see Ganpati immersion, you will, even if it is not convenient, you will come, no? Or to participate in Govinda, it's not convenient. Those cultural, what we call cultural functions, are very inconvenient functions, but we do attend to that because we think that's part of our culture. So we don't think that watching films with the whole neighborhood, usme chor bhi hai, aapke bhai bhi hai, it's not done. We don't think it's done anymore. That's it.
And where is this Samrat theater?
Samrat theater is in Goregaon West.
Where exactly?
All these theaters are very close to the railway line. That is also another thing. So you can see the city growing by the railway line, and then dotted around the railway line east and west are the cinema halls.
Both the cinema theaters and theaters.
Right? Theaters, yeah. Yeah. Actually, somebody said that multiplexes should start theaters. Actually, we are not aware of how many theaters Bombay has. I'm not talking about cinema theaters, performance theaters, drama house, as they used to call. Again, dotted along the lines. They are municipality owned, community, neighborhood theaters. I mean, after all, Maharashtra has a huge theater tradition, right? Those are made to get into disutility, you know. I mean, we don't even need new one, even if we can start making those function and function in a sustainable, reliable way. That will, I mean, we have the infrastructure, we are letting it ruin.
Hello, thank you for taking us through this. As I was watching that clipping, Aamir Khan's clipping, so this thing, this one thing came into my mind. Apart from dreams, apart from labor, consumers, as you mentioned just now, an industry also invites corruption. So I know this selling ticket in black is something very basic, and much bigger and layered things are there in between. So I did not see much of that here. And I really want to know, what is your take on the evolvement of corruption? Like, it has played, definitely played a quite a big role behind how we are today, right now, the theatres, the condition of the theatres. So how would you?
No, no, I mean, ultimately, everything is run in this city, at least, and mostly on all cities, on real estate. Is the real estate which is at the and theater movement is definitely, I mean, this demolish the theater movement, is not the theater movement, is definitely real estate. But there is other corruptions also. But you know what, we okay, it's happening everywhere. Like, public places are taken, playground is taken away, children's has no place to play. All these are there. We are aware of it, and we are angry of it also. My concern is that we are not so angry about single screen cinema, because we are thinking, "Acha hai na yaar, wo koi city nahi bajata hai, garmi nahi lagta hai, bada pav wale andar nahi aa jate hai." We watch film properly, so we don't mind single screen cinema going. So I'm just making you aware that with single screen cinema, what is going away is a public culture. And by tomorrow, when you realize that a kind of public culture which kept the urban community together is gone, it will be too late, because there will be no space left for us. Of course, the main reason why it will not be left for us to do anything is the real estate. And real estate, as you know, in Bombay, I mean, this is, who am I to say, it's every day's murder story. But what we are, do we know what we are missing? Because we are quite okay about it. We are thinking that we are into much better condition to watch films, is it? Because these are not delicate films. Right? These are robust films. It pure logo ke saath raste mein baith ke dekhne ka maza hi kuch alag tha. This is robust culture. This is not classical music. I mean, there are also that kind of cinema. So cinema also needs different kind of things. But that community culture is going. I'm only lamenting that in this piece. Yeah. Well, I tried to lobby with the single screen theater owners that if you get a better tax deal, don't pay like this 9 rupees over every 20 rupees ticket. I told them that let us cultivate journalists and all and lobby with them. They will write about it. They're not interested, because they are trying to lure the real estate people, I mean the builders, to come in. So you and I think that they should get a better deal, but they think what better deal is very different than what you and I think is a better deal. Yeah, that's also true. They are businessmen.
So also they want to show that their business is not doing well.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
That they can appeal to the government.
And unfortunately, actually, it's going pretty well. I mean, a single screen theater is always far more full than multiplexes with blockbusters. They get old films. You may remember this Bharat Mata, which is under so much controversy. So many times builders came to demolish it. Only on Marathi sentiment it could be saved. Only Shiv Sena could save it by saying that this is the only exclusive cinema hall to show Marathi cinema. Now, not that Shiv Sena cannot go with the builders, but at that moment they could save it. Only on that, not because of anything else. But for how long? I mean, and only 3 years back, there was so much crowd for one hit Marathi film, there was a murder. I mean, when is there a murder for ticket? That means the tickets are really selling well, right? I mean, when black happens, when murder happens, I mean, some crime also shows that it is lucrative. Yes. And the owner was most upset over that. Not because there was a murder and he was interrogated by the police. He said, now people will think that I'm doing good business.
As we see here, that government introduced less taxes for the growth of multiplexes. But then again, on the other hand, watching a movie is one of the most taxed industries. So I don't know how that functions. I mean,
I didn't get you.
Okay, so there were a lot of Marathi films recently that were made tax-free, and I remember that the ticket that used to be 80 suddenly came down to 55, 60. So that was because those were tax-free. So government is charging so much tax.
So these are two things, no? Look, the people who make film has nothing to do with multiplex, has pay how much tax or single screens. That's distributor, that is theater owners. So film is produced, film is a commodity. Then the commodity is out in the market, in the shop, it belongs to shop owner. So these taxes are different, and taxpayers are also different. Then you pay tax on everything, that's another thing, okay? Yeah.
Totally agree with you about the single screen and also the romance of it, because obviously, you know, as kids we've, you know, grown up with that, and that's also brought us to cinema. But especially in your presentation today, it got me more and more thinking about the multiplex thing, because it's not, it's all okay, yeah, the real estate and everything, but if you remember, the single screens were also a part of, you know, more normal kind of bazaars, and that was also kind of a public. So it's almost like a different kind of a capitalist marketplace economy is being imposed.
Yes,
so it's
true.
Also then
true.
Means how much of a choice.
True.
I mean, it's like a change of,
true.
You know.
True.
So.
Yeah, I mean, true. You have a point there. No, you have a point there. It was a horizontal bazaar to vertical bazaar. I mean, why can't we look at it that way?
Yeah, and everything that goes with it, including the parking spaces. Now you go underground. You know, otherwise in the bazaar you are looking for it.
But you remember, I mean, one thing I didn't touch because it was getting late, ki there is also theaters used to produce lots of livelihood, other than Amir Khan selling a black ticket, which is also a livelihood. Cassette, horoscope, salon, poster wala, there is layers and layers and layers of thing. So not that always you go to cinema hall to see a film, you also go to hang around, to see women. I'm sure women also used to go to see boys. And then there will be a bar, there will be a fashion saloon, there will be a poster wala, there will be a horoscope wala, there will be a tanga wala. So it used to be a small establishment, nothing to do with the films actually. So those are also going, nimbu or sharbat wala. Now multiplexes may, as you know, you cannot take your own sandwich. You'll have to buy those branded things only. Anyway, I think we end it here. Yeah. Oh, okay.
The panwala outside Minerva after Shole got two flats from the tickets.
Exactly. So you can have a look at it. This is my colleague Paroma has made when we were doing this project. This is a map of all the people who live off and around the cinema theater. It's a small thing because you need to see, and all sorts of stories. Hashish smoker who will always come there at 9 o'clock and tell some stories. All sorts of neighborhood culture, which is around the cinema hall, but nothing to do with films. None of them know how to make films, but it is around that. So you can just have a look at it. Yeah, there are two. So. That's it is, but think about it, is it? Let us think. I mean, I don't want to pass a moral judgment. No, who am I or who are you? But let us think about it. I mean, we are definitely losing something and gaining something else. But yeah, we should have a index of what we are losing. Yeah. What do you think? You tell me.
And we can just download movies online and.
Of course, you can. Is it the same thing? What do you think? Yeah, it's good for the filmmakers because they're getting the eyeballs, right? They want eyeballs. But is it okay for our kind of public life? I mean, do we long for a public life? You may say, I don't want a public life. I'm happy with my laptop and my Twitter. You may say that, which is okay. I mean, that's valid. I mean, who am I to say yours is not a valid way of leading a lifestyle? But I think if we're interested in public life, then we should have some kind of stake in this kind of activism, jatra, neighborhood performance art halls and single screen cinemas.
If I can say something to just build on that.
Jatra still happens in Bengal.
No, but it's not that. It's you have to answer about urban culture or any culture.
I mean, if you think of it a little socially, a little politically, in any kind of urban culture, when you do not meet and mix with other people, those people become other very fast.
Yes, yes.
And that is actually one of the reasons to be alert or aware of the loss of that public. Even us coming together here, a lot of us are strangers, right? We may never become friends, it may not matter. But at this moment, as strangers, one has come together and collectively shared something. These collective spaces are going down. Cinema, all these spaces used to be massive collective spaces. So in a way where the city came and recognized that all of us were the city, those places of recognition are going down. And the repercussions are not in cinema. So when you're saying that cinema is the anchor, we are looking through cinema. And like Madhushree was saying, we can look through any other collective activity, like sports. You're looking through it to understand what is getting lost and morphed, but we also think of what the repercussions are in other spaces. And we are feeling the repercussions today. The othering of people is really easy today. In a sense, and that is a loss, if it depends on what your way you look at the world, but you can, for someone like me, I would see it as a loss to our humanity. Because if I cannot recognize that everybody is a part of the world that I inhabit, then it's much easier for me to say, you have no right in this world. And we are hearing that a lot more, right? I mean, that's just my take on it.
Yeah, no, definitely, yeah. Completely, 100%, yeah.
Yeah, just to add to that, technology is isolating people. Actually, right now, I would say my dad sitting beside me has enjoyed his life more than what I'm doing right now. To be true, I mean, it's very honest. Secondly, I would say that, yeah, I mean, what she said was absolutely, I agree with that. We are losing that community thing. Of course, we're trying to do something new. Again, on Sunday, we have a marathon going on in Mumbai. So we are trying to maybe, slowly do something, but it's not happening. But still, I would say, comparatively, I've been in Delhi. I mean, Delhi doesn't have even one cultural festival compared to Mumbai, I would say. Mumbai has the Ganesh festival. It's a big thing. People come together. But Delhi was, it sucks. Seriously. It has nothing there. I do. Yeah. Yeah, but I would say, comparatively, I would say Mumbai is culturally the best city, I would say. Even Pune and... Yeah, it depends. Yeah. Yeah, sorry.
Yeah.
So I think with that, we end this beautiful session. Thank you so much, Madhushree ji, for this lovely session.